massive, massive 3 points for Aston Villa. Absolutely huge, huge in the magnitude of this season. What have we just witnessed in this game? It's been, in that second half, absolute torture watching it. I've had so many emotions in this game of watching us be unplayable at times. The control was there. Disorganization was there. Chaos was there. Fighting back was the mentality that we had. And in adversity, we just kept going. And this squad and this team have got something. And it's absolutely fantastic. Aston Villa have beaten Luton 3-2. And what I felt like this game would be at half-time coming on here, I was thinking, I'm just going to be like waxing lyrical about how well we've played. And then second half, so many emotions of throwing it away. And the one thing that I just kept thinking of in my head was Stoke. I just kept thinking of being 2-0 up and Stoke coming back against us all those years under Martin O'Neill. And then Unai makes those substitutions and Luca Dean and Diaby combine together to get the winning goal. And, you know, there's just a sense of relief, pride, passion, a sense of it's there for us, a sense of there's something happening for Aston Villa this season. And I saw it against Nottingham Forest and Liverpool. There's something happening there. And there's something that's happened today for Villa to get that victory. And all of those narratives of, you know, I imagine people when it was 2-2 were going, it's same old Villa. It's the Villa that we know. But the Villa now, the Villa that we know, our new Aston Villa, they don't do that. We come back and we get the victory to win 3-2. And it's just absolutely amazing. Like, my reaction when that third goal went in, oh my God, I was just bouncing off everywhere. And I was just like, Una, I was like, yeah, come on. But, oh my God, where to start? Where to start with this? Because it's huge. It's absolutely massive. And I've said this all season that, you know, it's a victory over Luton Town. Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. The magnitude of this victory is massive in the grand scheme of the season, of how many points hopefully we can now climb above Manchester United. You know, it sets us up so well for that game next week. What did I say this week? One game at a time. Focus on this game first. And then we can look to next week. And Luton did exactly what Luton do. And fair play to Luton, because second half, Luton were brilliant. They stuck it on us and we had to react and we had to dig deep. We had to dig deep to get that victory today. So fair play to Luton, but fair play to Aston Villa for having that inner strength to keep going. And even at 2-2, when some of them balls were going in the box, we had to be resolute and defend well. So I'm so proud of this Villa team today, because they've shown fight-back ability. They've shown an inner strength to get that victory. And this will do so much for us. You know, you look at beating Man City at home, beating Arsenal. What can that do for the squad? But what can this victory do for us? Three away wins in a row now, which is absolutely massive. And all of these little moments, and again, I said it so many times this season, that during a season, a team has moments, little moments to all the way through a season you will have. And those moments are big. We've had big moments already. We've had big moments against Man City, big moments against Arsenal. We've beat Chelsea. We've beat Spurs. We've had all different things thrown at us. And this was another one of those moments that at the end of the season, we'll look back and think that Luton victory is absolutely huge. So I'm over the moon with it, really. And let me know in the comment section. down below how you're feeling. If you are as buzzing as me, smash a like, subscribe to this channel. So I'm going to try and go back now and clear my mind of what's just happened. Konsa came back in. Power was on the bench. And first half, I thought we were absolutely outstanding. Outstanding. And for all of the good stuff that Luton did second half, the good stuff that we did first half was adapting to that Luton press. That Luton press first half came at us. They came at us. They were aggressive. They were man for man. But our ability on the ball that first half was out of this world. We were knocking it round them in tight areas. We were keeping possession. We were playing through them. We were fast. We were direct. We were clinical. We were absolutely brilliant with the ball. And that is the one thing that I was saying that first half, that I think that is one of the best we've played with the ball under a Luton Town press. We had chances. We had McGinn driving forward. We had Ramsey, who made a fine save off their keeper. Tielemans and Watkins were cutting out passing lanes centrally to Clark. I felt like that was really good that we were doing in the first half. And then Watkins, bullet header. What a header that is. An absolute bullet header. It is brilliant. They got let off with the Dougie Louise one first time round. But Ollie Watkins' header, unreal. Ollie Watkins' hold-up play. Ollie Watkins' dribbling and running through the channels. He's finishing in that first half. Like I said a couple of games ago, and like I keep saying, Ollie Watkins was absolutely unplayable in that first half. He was tremendous. We then bring on Rodgers for Ramsey, and Rodgers starts looking a little bit lively as well. He looked really good in that first half, taking up that Ramsey role. And then the beautiful no-look free kick from Douglas Luiz to Ollie Watkins. Ollie Watkins' touch and finish was absolutely majestic, clinical, 2-0 Aston Villa. Rodgers then has a great strike and the keeper makes a brilliant save. And we were just brilliant first half. Simply outplayed them, outclassed them. We had complete control. I thought we were scintillating at times in that first half. And I couldn't fault it. And I just thought it was just going to be one-way traffic. Villa come out second half. We just continue what we're doing and we win this game comfortably. But Luton stuck it on us big time. And we really started to lose our way, lose our control. The one thing that I'll always say to you guys is, did Aston Villa control it? First half, yes. Second half, no control whatsoever. We started giving away silly free kicks. We started making loose decisions with the ball. We started to get overloaded, especially on that right-hand side. I felt like Rodgers really struggled. Moreno was struggling as well without any protection. And we just started to get overloaded. Their player on that right-hand side was just ripping us completely. And we looked disjointed, unorganised, and we looked really suspect. I think it was Kabore who was exposing us. And then, you know, the balls kept going in and they scored through Chong. Brilliant clearance off the line. I think it was Cash. And then Chong sticks it away and 2-1 down there. I mean, well, 2-1 up and you're having problems because they only looked like there was going to be one winner at that point for me. Morris then gets a brilliant goal, cross towards that back post. And I was fearing for Villa. I've got to be honest, I was really fearing for us. We were rocky, we were edgy, we were on the ropes. We looked like we had no control. And then Unai makes four changes and we were absolutely a little bit better when we make those changes. We just looked more dynamic. We had more pace. We had more power. We were starting to edge to get a little bit more control. And then I've got to talk about Moussa Diaby, because there was one moment where he ran a channel and I thought he's just got to keep doing that. And then that ball to Luca Dean was absolutely unbelievable. It was fantastic. It was pacey. It had whip on it. And then that finish from Luca Dean at that far post was unbelievable. And my scenes were, I was just reacting like a mad, like I was possessed really. But just so much emotion. Like we will learn a lot from that to keep going and not sort of, you know, just have that belief to keep going and that desire. And like I say, I feel like there's something happening here now, and we just look sort of formidable at times. So we're going to now go and do the player ratings, and we'll put the Villa players in our rating system. And in the chat, you can tell me who your man of the match is as well. So we'll kick it off then, and we'll go with Emi Martinez. I thought Martinez was brilliant on them, you know, defending those set pieces, coming out, catching. You know, he was sort of giving us that little bit of sense of security at times. So I thought Martinez had a really good game. Konsa, I thought, was really good on the ball as well. I thought he was good aerially. And he had a lot of composure, and especially in that first half, his passing range was really good. Cash, I'm going to go in the middle with Cash. I thought Cash was, you know, he was good defensively first half. He was good on the ball first half. Second half, he was up against Chong, and that was, you know, that was a real battle. It was like hustle and bustle between the two of them. And we had to dig in, and we had to fight, and we had to sort of scrap away. And I think Cash's tenacity was really, really good. So I thought Cash again looked good defensively. He was good. Didn't really put a foot wrong. Cleared it off the line, and then Chong put it away. But, you know, it was great defending from Cash in that moment. Luca Dean, I'm sticking him in player of the match to start with. And we'll see where we go with Luca Dean, because to come on and get that winner, you know, what a header. Unbelievable. So Luca Dean's going in there. Dougie Luiz, I thought he was okay-ish second half. A little bit loose. We lost our control. We lost a little bit of a grip on the game. But all in all, the delivery for that second goal from Luiz was absolutely outstanding. Tielemans, I'll go average. I think he was pressing okay. Didn't really get involved too much towards that second half. And that second half's in my mind quite a lot. So that's, you know, I've got to balance it out and balance my thoughts of how good Luton were as well. McGinn, I felt like he was okay. Again, lost the grip on it second half. First half, he was dictating play. We just got really loose with our decision-making second half. And there was a lot of fouls, a lot of needless fouls. And I know that's the pressure of playing Luton, but yeah, McGinn, I'm going average for McGinn. If I have a bit of a mare, I'm in a bit of a Villa win haze in my mind. So you'll have to excuse if I have a bit of a mare with some of them. Diaby, again, he's going to go in class for that delivery. Absolutely world-class delivery from Diaby. And it was just an absolute brilliant, brilliant ball in. Watkins, unplayable. His two goals were unreal. 16 goals now for the season, I think he's on. And that is just unreal numbers. He's going to get 20 goals for Aston Villa this season. The header, bullet. The shot he scored, great control and a great finish as well. Zaniolo will go okay. You know, he needs to look after the ball a lot more. Moreno will go okay for Moreno. He'll be average as well. You know, it was a really difficult game for him to defend. And, you know, I felt like he was okay. Next up, we will go with, let's have a look who we've still got to come. Longley, absolutely brilliant. Outstanding Longley. His distribution, his clearances. There was that one moment with him and Martinez, and I felt like he was, you know, we did well to just clear it and get rid of it because of their mix-up. We'll go Rodgers, okay. I felt first half really good on the ball in that Ramsey role, driving us forward. Second half defensively looked like he needs to learn this Unai role, because he was just getting turned. He was getting passed through. He wasn't blocking off that ball to their sort of right, wide right players. So I think Rodgers has still got quite a lot to learn defensively in this Villa system. But with the ball, offensively, very, very bright. Bailey, class. Bailey was class. You know, defensively, second half, I felt like he was Villa's best player. And he was brilliant, Bailey. So Bailey's close. Bailey, I'm telling you now, Bailey's close to being man of the match, because defensively in that second half, he was brilliant. You know, offensively, he was driving us forward. Bailey had a really, really strong game. Ramsey was, you know, okay, driving us forward. Irabunum, a little bit loose defensively as well, giving away a few needless fouls as well. So they both can go in there. And that's it, basically. So we're going to go man of the match. Has to be Ollie Watkins. Unplayable. What a striker. What a player. Unbelievable. So yeah, Villa, 3-2. And it's difficult. You know, I knew it was going to be. I said in the preview and the predicted lineup, this Luton team do not know when they have lost. They keep going. They keep fighting. And, you know, for people that were just saying, you know, rest players, it's just Luton and this and that. You've got to take every game seriously now in the Premier League. They're all very, very difficult and they all hold their own importance now. So now we can think about Ajax. Can't think about Spurs yet. We've got to think about Ajax because that is the game that's up next. A big week ahead, Ajax and Spurs. But my focus, Unai's focus, will be on Ajax. And I'm just absolutely buzzing. You know, this victory is probably our biggest victory of the season. And we're playing Luton Town. So that is shows how good Luton were. It shows how big of a game this Luton game was. Even though that they're in the relegation zone, beating Luton is one of the biggest victories Villa have had this season because of the magnitude of what it means. You see it all the time, don't you? How many times did United always come back and win? Liverpool today, come back and won. City, play poorly and win. I've said it as well this season. Play poorly and win. You have to keep going. You have to keep grinding out the victories. And yeah, you might look at it and think, we were poor second half. On another day, we won't win, blah, blah, blah. But we've won. And that is absolutely huge. So I'm buzzing. Great victory. Means so much. Up the Villa. Come on.